can I say this? We don't give it our undivided attention. See, all of these beautiful, wonderful scriptures, it just makes me so happy. Boy, sometimes I'll be in such a load until I just feel like, and all I have to do is go back to my God's eager, yearning scriptures and remember what it says and start singing and start singing. Now, I can't help it because all of my prayers now is turned into songs. Amen. But God is what? Amen. He is what? He's what? Sun and shield. Everybody say he's a sun and shield.
He's a sun and shield.
He's a sun. Maybe you don't even know what that means. I don't know what it all, yeah, all means either. But he gives grace. I know what that means. He gives what? Grace and glory.
Yes.
Isn't that good? Amen. He gives what? Grace and glory.
Amen.
And what? No! No good thing.
Yes.
Amen. I ought to shout it 7 times. Wake y'all up. Because you ain't, amen. If you don't, if you ain't going to say it, I'm going to say it.
Yes.
It's working for me.
Yes.
No good thing.
No good thing.
No good thing.
You may say it 7 times. No good thing.
No good thing.
No good thing.
No good thing.
Now listen to this. Listen to this.
No good thing.
Are you standing with conviction? A conviction of you standing because what? I told you to say it.
No good thing.
No good thing. Put your hands up again. No good thing.
No good thing.
No.
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 Woo! Will he withhold? I'm trying to get over y'all. God ain't is not a withholder.
Amen.
All right. He's not a withholder.
Woo.
Amen.
Boy, if that message become rhema, I mean the portion. Now I had planned this evening to have all of this teaching and all of that typed up and pass it out, but I said, I got to check before I even come out here because nobody might not even come. Amen. So that's a part of the problem. Now who's that said I cherish God's word more than my necessary food? Who's that said that? Amen. Praise God. How many know that God is for you?
Amen.
He's for me. Tell yourself, God is for me.
God is for me.
Tell yourself that again. God is for me.
God is for me.
Say it again.
God is for me.
If you can convince yourself of that simple principle, one, that's step one. And I got about 15 pages trying to help you to be convinced. But it won't help you if you don't read it. If you don't say it, if you don't agree with it. Then the second step would be knowing who you are. And we're going to work with that, knowing who you are. Woo-wee. All of these things, the reality of your redemption, the reality of your comfort, the fact that you are a new creation, the reality of, amen, that you that God's power is dwelling, God's indwelling power is in you. The reality of his righteousness, all of these things have to be quickened before you establish in that aspect of the grace of God. Everybody say amen.
Amen.
I mean, the grace of God that brings salvation has appeared unto all men. Okay, what does it teach us? That we have to what? Deny ungodliness. That we got to live what? Righteously, godly,
yes,
and soberly right here in this what? Present.
Yes.
Everybody say amen.
Amen.
Everybody say amen.
Amen.
Everybody say amen.
Amen.
How many are willing to pay the price?
Amen.
How many are willing to make the sacrifice?
Yes.
To have God's best.
Yes.
It's not just going to come on days of ease.
Yes.
Amen. It's God's good pleasure to give us the kingdom, but the Bible says the kingdom of heaven suffered what? Violence. But the what? Violence will what?
Take it by force.
Amen. Here is my prayer. Here's my amen, because we need this as a body. We need this individually. We need this corporately. We need to be established in God's what? Grace. Scripture, Hebrews 13, is a good thing to be established in what? In grace. Everybody say amen.
Amen.
How many are willing to pay the price and make the commitment to get established in what? Grace. Amen. I want you to stand wherever you are. Hey, blah, blah, blah.